Sometimes there's
just that fear of kind of dropping everything to go for it. You know, a lot of people are comfortable in their day office jobs, but it's a job and it's comfortable, and I never saw myself doing that.
I first started homebrewing with my dad.
I got to a certain point where I was just so obsessed that I was like, how can I just do this for a living, you know?
My friend Allie had some money from a car accident
that she was willing to open a brewery with. She unfortunately passed away from some organ failure from the accident. And one of the last things Allie said to me was, you know, I'm sorry, I'm not gonna help you open your brewery. And then from there, I was just kind of, you know, went on the back burner.
I was a contractor for 2 years.
Doing pretty well, and to start a business like this, you don't see any profit for basically years.
And then I made all the beer at my wedding.
I had multiple people come up to me and say, you know, if you don't pursue opening a brewery, like, I'm gonna be mad at you, like, basically. So I was like, well, okay, I mean, I guess it's pretty good and I like doing it, so maybe I should just go for it.
The passing of Allie just really, you know, gave me even more drive to move forward with the brewery.
I obviously knew I couldn't do it by myself.
I've known Frank for a long time. Him and Taylor grew up with my younger brother.
When Nick brought it up, I remember thinking to myself, like, this is it. This is that calling. This is what I want to be a part of.
I was pretty hesitant for at least a month, thinking this town is full of breweries. There's a lot of competition. We found a space in SoCal after about 6 months of searching.
The landlord wanted to see 130 grand, so we had a month to raise 130 grand.
Craft beer is not at all a trend.
We've definitely failed on pitching a lot of investors, especially the early ones that just never got back to us, and it's kind of awkward.
We kind of had our backs up against the wall. We needed money in our bank account, so we reached out to our community and we raised what we needed in a month, which is crazy. We built it up in our minds that we kind of like had found it, we were done.
And after we had an engineer look at it, we realized it was going to be too costly to get it to work for us.
Here we are living at my wife's grandma's house, because that's all we can do right now.
Quite a while to find that second spot.
We have these big pieces of equipment. This is a real brewery now.
Same time, we have only paid $67,000 of the $230,000 brew house. If we don't get the rest of the money, I'm not really sure what's going to happen with the equipment. But that's kind of part of starting a business, is you just have no idea what's going to happen. So when we started Humble Sea, we wanted to create a brewery in a community that makes a positive change. Whether it's, you know, a community gathering or just the traditional sense of a public house, which is, hey, this is a space for everyone in the public to go grab a beer, talk politics, make change, or simply hang out and connect with people. Thank you.